for 2021 prospect Jason Nelson.
And Jason Nelson.
And Jason, for you coming in from Verona.
I think the favorite thing I have about Jason.
And I'm here with Jason Nelson.
Before the prospect, I always seen Jay Nell as a great kid.
My favorite memory of Jason as a child is that when I used to keep him, and he used to just sit there and just smile. He didn't talk back to you, and even to this day, he just was an easygoing person, real nice young man, very nice, and I'm proud of him.
My favorite memory of little Jason was watching him and Tyrone Jr. play basketball against each other, seeing which one was the best. They argue and fuss all the time. They love each other, but they stay in an argument all the time. He just didn't like to lose when he played sports. And I like that about him, because I knew that event one day, that with that competitive in him, it will pay off for him.
My favorite things about Jason would be that he's full of life, he's passionate, and he's a leader who's goal-driven. My most memorable moment with Jason was when he won his first high school state championship. He's always known for being so humble and so relaxed that in that moment, people were able to see emotions that he doesn't normally show. It was kind of like, I did it. I actually did it. Whichever college Jason decides to choose, they would be gaining a scholar athlete who's a hard worker and determined to do whatever it takes to be successful.
Jason been playing sports since he was barely able to walk. And I think winning just became a part of him. So as a kid, he done all the little things to be able to be in the position that he could possibly be in, as far as working hard, waking up early in the morning, going to sleep late, push-ups, sit-ups, lifting weights. I think that he done all the things that he can do is to possibly put him in the best position to be able to compete at all levels. As a father, you always want your kids to be better than what you are. So as a former Division II athlete, when I noticed that my son took interest in basketball, my goal was to help prepare him to be able to be the best that he can be, not only the best that he can be, but to be better than me. My greatest accomplishment as of him is to sit here today, to be able to be in this position, to be talking about two schools.
Jason has always been a heart over height guy. He has been very competitive since I've known him. His dad used to bring him in the gym as an infant. He's been around basketball all of his life. He is so competitive. I remember that as he was 5 years old. So the things he's doing now doesn't surprise me, because he's always had that competitive spirit and work ethic as a blue-collar worker to get things done. My favorite memory goes back to EUIB, and it was my first team that I coached as a parent, and as well as 5 and 6 year olds, and me and Jason's dad were the coaches for the team. And Jason actually hit a half court winning shot that won us a championship, which was my first championship in the Little League.
Man, I knew once he was in sixth grade that I would be lucky enough. I would be lucky enough to coach him. I knew he was going to be a starter from day one. There were a lot of kids who tried out that wanted his spot, but he was head and shoulders above everybody else just because of his work ethic and his skill set. And he just had a mindset like in sixth grade of somebody that was in high school or even college. He would be putting up shots at 6 a.m. before middle school. This is like a middle school kid, putting up shots at 6 a.m., just coming into the gym at 6. His work ethic was, incredible. I knew he was going to be ready for game day.
I met him when he was probably in the sixth grade, but I didn't start working out with him until he got in the eighth grade. We're going to ninth grade that summer. He was always one of the best guys around here, so he really didn't need training to get better as in with his skills, because he already had the skills. I think he just needed, more confidence. As a ninth grader, you never seen, like I said, he's very poised. Getting in the gym, he's telling everybody else, let's get in the gym, let's work out. He just led the way, no matter what. He never had a bad attitude. He always asking how could he get better. And, you know, I think that's going to be one of the great things that's going to help him out when he go to college.
So we got in, he finally came in as a freshman. He had the ball in his hand. The number one thing I knew that he was going to be doing, he didn't even turn it over. He understood as a freshman how to run a team. And I had always said, I was like, man, this kid's going to be special, because you understood he knew how to score, but he didn't have to score. That's where he got the nickname, PG1, came from that freshman year. In the championship run, he came into a sophomore year, and we had a conversation. And I said, hey, you know, so man, you got to get better at scoring the basketball on your outside shot. And he came in as a sophomore year. I mean, he had 7 threes in one game at a Renko, and you could start to see that he puts in his game what he needs to be successful.
I knew J-Nell was going to be as good as he is today back in elementary school when I first met him. He always just had something in him. I don't know what it was, but he just always went hard and just played as hard as he could. His role was PG1. He just ran the show for real. It was crazy because he was so young, but his IQ always been just far ahead of his age group, so he just ran the show.
If I could describe him in one word, I would say elite. Not because he's a five-star blue chip recruit, but an elite because the package that his game comes in, from ball handling to taking it to the basket, to passing, to shooting, to defending, to IQ, to academic, to a leader, is at a different level. Doesn't matter what team he's on and what players are around him, he demands their trust. They put their trust into him as well.
My favorite memory of Jason Nelson was we were playing a championship game in Hampton at the Southern Jam Fest, and our backup point guard got hurt, and Jason had to play 32 minutes the whole game against a really tough Team Thrill Baltimore team that picked up man-to-man full court, and he stepped up to that challenge and quarterback and led our team to the first Southern Jam Fest championship for the Team Loaded program. And we basically used timeouts just to get him a break because he was our lead point guard, and we needed him in the game. He's the ultimate closer. We don't go 40-0 without Jason Nelson. Let's be clear about that. Again, a point guard that's a leader and a winner. When the moment is never too big, and the quiet confidence that he always exhibited, that's why he's going to do really great at either school he decides to go to.
Jason, to be described in one word, would be winner. Jason Nelson and winningness should always be synonymous. He's done it on every level, from high school, from AAU, Verona, here at John Marshall. He's just a winner. He's the ultimate winner. The thing that intrigued me about Jason as a prospect, I just love tough guys, guys who are willing to put it all on the line for his team to be successful. He's tough, he's relentless. He won't allow his team to lose. He would do whatever it takes for his team to win, from rebounding, to defending, to scoring, to passing. Things I say about him all the time, he just knows when. He knows when to score, he knows when to pass, he knows when to step it up, he knows when to be vocal, he just knows when.
My favorite memory will always and forever be with Jason, the late nights and early mornings that we would spend in the gym. They had a game this past year when they played Sierra Canyon. And his mindset, it probably wasn't one of his best games. And right after that game, he went straight to the gym, and we was in there for another 2.5 hours. I know Jason Nelson was going to be the player he was in ninth grade. The reason why I say that is in ninth grade, Jason was starting to come into his own, as well as playing with a lot of the top talent all on one team versus the country. And with doing that, he was always the catalyst, he was always the leader, he always won the games by seeing everybody else through. That's when I knew.
If I could describe Jason in one word, it would probably have to just be a dog.
He is dynamic.
He was a good kid.
With this one word, winner.
Extremely humble.
Winner, ultimate winner.
Leader.
Elite.
humble.
Winner. He's the ultimate winner. And I know people that you talk to will continue to hear that and say that about Jason. To win in his career already, to win two state titles and a national championship through the Adidas circuit and have another year to play, this kid could potentially win three state championships. I don't know that. I don't know many people who have won. He's potentially about to have three state championships along with a national championship. He's the ultimate winner.
First off, I'd like to thank God for giving me the talent to play this game called basketball. Second, I'd like to thank my parents for always being there no matter what it was through all my ups and downs. Third off, I'd like to thank all my coaches and trainers for always pushing me to be the best I can be. And fourth, I'd like to thank all the universities that recruited me, that took the time out to talk to me, especially my top two, Vanderbilt and Richmond. But there can only be one. And with that being said, I'd like to announce that I've been committed to the University of...
Hey, my name is Jason. Welcome to my new stage.
Big stage, you never heard peace till you hear people scream your name in unison. I'm so far away from the place I used to be. Struggling usually. Look at the new me. Fate pursuing me. I can feel the energy in the air. It feel like I'm supposed to be here.
Everywhere I go, I'm getting so much love. Fans and stars, everyone saying how they can't wait for the OP.
Richmond. Go Spiders.
Feel so good in what you do. Help somebody else get through. That's why I do the best I can, because I know how blessed I am.
I'm so high, I can touch the sky. I know it's my time, and it's now or never. Shine so bright, I light the night, and it feels so right. Ain't nothing better.
A fool if I take it all for granted, a smart man if I keep my feet planted to the earth, cause the people that hurt can understand it. You speaking my language, I'ma show you how to make it all work. Another planet is a short term goal for me.
You like it?
Soul for me, it's just more of me in your ear. For you to hear Kendrick persevere, defenses I feel relentless. Ambition with a clear vision, taking off, I ain't taking off these pistons. I'm taking off on the enemy, your distance came across me. How much it'll cost me to get you out my business. I said a planet is a short term goal, no sky is the limit. I'm past that, now past that. Award not one, but four times two plus yours.
I see myself performing at
K-Dot.
Sold out shows where the room is packed.
Uh-huh.
Sitting at the Grammys winning five awards. See myself on big billboards. Traveling around the world with endorsement deals. Can't imagine how it feels. That's why I'm smiling every day, because my dream ain't far away.
Looking at me and you tell me I'm blessed. Calculated my steps, my heart, my breath. Breathe lungs of a victory and vividly you see me when I'm at my best. My worst, this verse dedicated to the days that I slept with a curse. Research my pay dues, I'm reimbursed. I burst in the crowd with a voice and a crown. I'm a king on the prowl and I see mama smile and a vowel. I'ma take that I'll never break. You can break bread with me.